Welcome to the Alexander City Public Schools Virginia Preschool Initiative VPI program. Free preschool. ACPS offers free preschool to qualifying families through the VPI program. The purpose of VPI is to provide quality early childhood programs for eligible four-year-olds. Eligibility is based on family income and child and family risk factors. VPI is a program designed for families who might not otherwise access quality early childhood education opportunities. Limited capacity. Spaces are limited. Acceptance to the VPI program is not on a first-come, first-served basis. Qualifying families that complete registration will be placed on the waitlist until space becomes available. Eligibility requirements. Age: your child must be 4 years old by September 30th. Residency: your child must reside in the city of Alexandria. And income: the child's family must meet the annual gross U.S. federal poverty income eligibility guidelines or other risk factors. Program highlights. The VPI program is a free full-day preschool program. Every class is taught by a licensed teacher. Breakfast, lunch, and a snack are available. Dash Bus is free and available for parent or guardian to transport for pickup or drop-off. The school assignment is based on the nearest geographic serving school location. Programs are offered at the following four schools: the Early Childhood Center at John Adams Elementary School, Douglas MacArthur Elementary School, William Ramsey Elementary School, and Jefferson Houston School. We will now take a look at the VPI registration checklist. Registration forms, identification, medical documents, income verification, residency verification, and shared housing residence form. Now let's take a look one bullet at a time. The first thing is registration is by appointment only, Monday through Friday, from 9 a.m. to 1 p.m. Parent or guardian must schedule a phone screening appointment by visiting acpsvpi.setmore.com. You can also scan the QR code with your camera phone to schedule your phone appointment. The parent or legal guardian must provide all of the following documents during the registration process. Now, for the registration forms, you will need to complete the following forms: the home language survey, the student registration form, the residency verification and enrollment form, student health information form, the Commonwealth of Virginia School Entrance Health Form, Student Parent Survey, and the ACPS Signature Form. Please complete the online forms using this link, www.acps.k12.va.us/page/3073.
Age, required documents. Student must be 4 years old by September 30th. Original birth certificate. If the original birth certificate is not in English, an official translation is required. Passport or other ID is not an original birth certificate and may be used as a supporting document. Original parent or legal guardian ID to match birth certificate. Any valid government-issued photo ID identification may be used for parent or legal guardian. The name on the birth certificate should match the parent or guardian's picture ID or court document of legal custody. Next, medical required documents. Number 1, Commonwealth of Virginia School Entrance Health Form. 2, child's physical exam must be within a year. 3, tuberculosis, TB, screening, or test within a year. 4, updated full immunization record. Let's look at the forms. This is the first page of the Commonwealth of Virginia School Entrance Health Form. This form must be completed by the parent. The second form is the immunization. The doctor completes or attaches the immunization record. The third form is for the doctor to attach any documents. The last document of this form is for the doctor to complete and attach the physical and TB section. Here's another form the doctor can complete for a TB screening. This form must be completed within a year. Income verification. Please supply the following recent documents. Bring all that apply. So if you have any of these documents and if it applies to your family, please provide it during your registration. Income tax form 1040 may be used if income from the tax return is the current job that you currently hold. W-2, two recent pay stubs within 30 days. Unemployment and workers' compensation, SSI, Supplemental Security Income, temporary assistance for needy families such as called TANF and SNAP, Supplemental Nutrition Assistance Program. If you have a Medicaid letter, notarized income verification form, notarized unemployment verification form, income from education assistance, alimony and child support, income from estate and trust, rents and royalties, pension or retirement income, veterans benefit payment, foster care reimbursement, or financial assistance from outside the household. Please bring all that apply. Residency, lease, mortgage, or deed. Category A, provide one of the following documents in the parent or legal guardian's name with Alexandria City address. Full lease agreement, including current Alexandria City address, parent name, signature from parent and landlord, and the expiration date. Or mortgage contract or bill prepared by the lender, including the date, Alexandria address, and lender name within 60 days of registration or initial mortgage contract, with a current copy of the owner's property tax. Or deed. The property deed must be accompanied by a copy of owner's personal property tax. So you must provide one of the following: the full lease agreement, mortgage contract or bill, or deed. Residency. Two supporting documents. In addition to your lease, mortgage, or deed, you must provide two supporting documents, such as utility bill, water, gas, electric, cable, or internet, current personal Alexandria City property tax or bill, receipt, mail letter from the government agency, such as SNAP, TANF, HUD, ARHA, IRS, etc., current pay stub or tax return, two consecutive bank statements mailed to your home, two consecutive bank statements mailed to your home, and current homeowner or renter's insurance policy. And if you're new to your home and you just signed within 30 days, you have 30 days to notify and update us with two supporting documents. Residency shared housing document. This is required only if residing with someone else. The parent or guardian must complete a notarized shared housing form. So if you, the parent, do not have a lease, mortgage, or deed in your name, you will need to provide the Form A and B document notarized. Next, provide the original copy of the mortgage, deed, or lease for the person with whom the parent or legal guardian and child or children are living. Additionally, the parent or legal guardian is required to provide two supporting documents in the parent or legal guardian's name, as listed in the registration form. What does the Form A and B look like? Form A, the parent of the child. To complete this form must be notarized. So Form A must be completed by the parent or legal guardian. Form B is to be completed by the lease, mortgage, or deed holder. This form must be notarized. Next, here is a quick recap of the VPI registration checklist. Throughout this video, we reviewed how to register and what to provide for your registration appointment. The first thing on the checklist is the registration forms, identification, medical documents, income verification, residency verification, and shared housing documents.
Registration is by appointment only, Monday through Friday, from 9 a.m. to 1 p.m. Parent or guardian must schedule a phone screening appointment by visiting acpsvpi.setmore.com. You can also scan the QR code with your camera phone to schedule your phone appointment. That concludes our information session for the ACPS VPI program. Thanks for watching!